I love Christmas. We all love Christmas. We get to eat great food, spend quality time with the family and friends, and open presents. Yet, Christmas can be a season of great joy and fun-filled activities. It can also be a time of healing and renewed strength. It is a time of God showing His great love for us. You see, the Christmas story is one good news and great joy. Christmas is all about Jesus, who became a man and willingly died for our sins. Nothing has ever been the same since the first Christmas. It is with great pleasure to welcome all of you to GCC Elementary Choir Christmas Cantata, The Promise of Christmas.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we humbly come before you today to say thank you. Thank you for all the undeserved blessings and favor, and for constantly keeping your promises. Thank you for your daily presence, for your forgiveness on our shortcomings, and for the unconditional love you have shown us throughout this year. Father, may this Christmas cantata honor you and celebrate your birth more than it celebrates our own accomplishments, because we know that no accomplishments are possible without your blessings. We pray for each and every person here, Father, with a grateful heart and with a song of praise. We will bless your name. This is our prayer, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Shall we give reverence to the reading of God's words as Amaria Nisha Ching leads us in the scripture reading?
Galatians chapter 4, verses 4 to 6. The fulfillment of God's promise. But when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth His Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. May God bless the reading of His Word.
It is a great privilege and honor to listen to the President of Grace Christian College, Dr. Christine Tan, for the welcome remarks and Christmas message.
Greetings. I am delighted to welcome you to the Grace Christian College Elementary Choir Christmas Cantata entitled The Promise of Christmas. This is composed of choir members from grades 1 to 6 with special participation from the teachers and staff of the English Elementary Department under Supervisor Mrs. Basita C. At Christmas, we remember and celebrate the birth of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, a precious gift from God the Father to us. This musical highlights what we have in Jesus Christ. First, through Jesus Christ, we have the promise of forgiveness of sins. In Matthew 1:21, the angel said, "And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." So the very name Jesus means he shall save his people from their sins. All of us have sinned and fall short of God's glory and holiness. But God loves us so much that he provided a way for us to have our sins forgiven. God sent his Son Jesus Christ, who lived a perfect life on earth. But when he was around 33 years old, he died on the cross, paying the penalty for our sins. Through Jesus Christ, we have the promise, the opportunity of forgiveness of sins. Second, in Jesus, we have the presence of God himself. Matthew 1:22-23 explains that Jesus' birth fulfilled Isaiah 7:14 prophecy. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us." Jesus Christ is the second person of the Trinity. Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Jesus Christ is God. So God the Son took on earthly flesh. And what was he like? John 1:14 tells us, "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Emmanuel, God with us. We can read in the Gospels what God was like in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. God loves us so much that he came down to understand the difficulties of life on this earth. And Jesus embodied both grace and truth. Third, in Jesus is light to dispel the darkness of the world. John 8:12. Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Jesus is the light of the world. Light to know what is right and what is wrong. Light to guide us. In our life decisions and circumstances, perhaps some things we don't know what to do. Should we go left or right, forward or backward? But we can ask Jesus to guide us. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Fourth, in Jesus we have the only way to God the Father. John 14:6, Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. 1 Timothy 2:5 says, For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Jesus Christ. And Acts 4:12 tells us, Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. This is the gospel bridge. On the left side is sinful man. On the right side is holy God. And the only way for sinful man to have a relationship with the holy God is through Jesus Christ. All the good works we do, all the education we have, the science, religion, philosophies that we believe in, will not get us to heaven. The only way is if each one of us asks Jesus to forgive us our sins, ask Jesus to be our Savior from sin. And today, perhaps some of us are not sure of our relationship with God. Some of us are not sure, are we going to heaven when we die? What we can do is we can pray this prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying for my sins. Please come into my heart and forgive my sins. I now believe in Jesus Christ and trust in him alone as my personal Savior. Thank you, dear God, for giving me eternal life and abundant life in Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you very much for joining us today. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy Grace Christian College's The Promise of Christmas.
Promise of Christmas, more than the bright lights, gift-giving, merrymaking, and never-ending festivities that the season bring, we rejoice in the wondrous promises that the first Christmas bring. The promise of nearness. When Jesus came to earth, he came as a human being. In doing so, Christ bridged the gap between the holy God and sinful man, between divinity and humanity. Jesus Christ is Emmanuel, the God with us. the birth of Jesus, we have been given the privilege to know the God who is near, warm, and compassionate, and not a cold, distant God who does not care. His birth announces us to the eternal closeness of God. We don't look for God through Jesus' birth. He has found us. Once and for all, Christ has come into the world, sought us out, and ravished our hearts with His great love. Babe in a humble manger. He did not come as a judge or a punisher. Jesus came to save the world from eternal damnation.
Oh come, Emmanuel, and ransom
birth is the promise of free-for-nothing forgiveness. No one is outside His grace, mercy, forgiveness, and love. There is no bad thing you have done or will ever do that can separate us from His amazing and unconditional love. Salvation is God's gift. We only need to ask and receive forgiveness. For sending His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to earth is love. The birth of Christ is the stunning truth that God is on our side. He is here for us. Jesus came to the earth because He loves us too much to leave us in our sinful mess.
Behold the star, a host of angels.
us out of unconditional love and a burning desire to see us restored back into a relationship with God, even if it meant that the powerful God became a helpless baby, even if it meant that the everlasting King would ultimately be dying on the cross in our place so we can access heaven. Jesus will go to any length and do anything just to show that He loves us. He cares for us, and He wants the best for us.
Blessed Christmas! It was on a glorious night when Jesus was born in Bethlehem. A glorious night when God's promise of salvation to mankind started unfolding. How wonderful it is for our elementary choir members to be singing of God's promises fulfilled on this similarly glorious night. Songs that we heard tonight reminded us of God's love for mankind as prophesied in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Christmas is a time of promise and expectation. For children, perhaps it is the promise of Christmas morning, excitement, discovery of new toys and clothes. For adults, perhaps it is a promise of rest after the hustle and bustle of the season. Tonight's cantata, aptly entitled The Promise of Christmas, led us to think about Christmas in a different way. Christmas is the promise of God's great love for mankind. The Bible, in John chapter 3, verse 16, says, For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. It made us ponder and wonder why God would choose to love us in spite of our sinfulness. It enabled us to realize his mercy and forgiveness that bring us hope for an eternal life with him. It moved us to accept him as our Lord and Savior. It brought us down to our knees to worship him and sing with the angels, glory to God in the highest and peace on earth and goodwill to man. We rejoice because Emmanuel, God is with us. The virtual Christmas cantata tonight is a testament of God's great love and goodness. The songs express the true essence of Christmas, while the singers are the living testimonies of God's grace. God is good that he made this project possible through the efforts of our music teachers in the elementary department, headed by Teacher Abby and Teacher Debbie. Numerous staff working behind the scene, and more than 100 elementary students as choir members, and the participation of about 50 teachers and staff in the department. Of course, we cannot not mention the partnership of our dear parents as they assist their kids in tech matters, the support of our GCC board chairman, Dr. James Tan, and the encouragement of our beloved Dr. Christine Tan, both of whom are very good singers themselves, are important factors that made this project on its second year a reality. To God be all glory. Thank you for joining us tonight. May we enjoy a meaningful and Christ-centered Christmas with our family. God bless us all.
At this point, let us sing the school hymn, Wonderful Grace of Jesus, to be rendered by the selected English elementary choir members.
Wonderful Grace of Jesus.
request Joaquin Ethan Borromeo to lead us in a closing prayer.
Let us pray. As I pray, I close my eyes, bow my head, and fold my hands together. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the successful conclusion of this Christmas cantata. We thank you for all the people who have generously shared their precious time with us. May each of us remember that this season should be a time of joy, generosity, forgiveness, and love. Your daily presence in our lives gives us the assurance your heart is toward us, your eyes over us, and your ears open to our prayers. We are always safe in your divine care. Thank you for sending your Son on one glorious night. Thank you for loving the whole world enough to send us the greatest immeasurable gift, your Son, Jesus Christ. You are our joy, our peace, our hope. We celebrate your birth and your life this Christmas and always. Happy birthday, Jesus. This is our prayer in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We can truly be happy at Christmas. God's promises never fail. No matter what may be happening, we can know that we are His children. Look at Christmas in a new way this year. This is the year to invite Jesus in your heart. He is with us, He forgives, and He loves unconditionally, more than we can ever imagine. We then become sons and daughters of God. Heaven will be our home one day. The joy and peace you will receive will last all year as you hold on to Him and His promises. You will then have a Merry Christmas. Thank you everyone for gracing this affair. Have a blessed Christmas and a prosperous New Year. May God bless you and your family.